obviously an emotional, intense game. How did you feel about the way you guys played?
I thought we competed, you know. Told them physically we competed extremely hard. We didn't always play as smart as I would like, but can't fault the effort. Gave ourselves a chance, and right there with about 4 minutes to go down five with the basketball. So, but give them credit. They stepped up 26 of 30 from the free throw line, and that's the difference in the basketball game.
Considering, Coach, that Montrez wasn't there and you guys missed a bunch of free throws, do you feel optimistic or do you feel like you guys missed an opportunity?
Anytime I lose, I feel like we missed an opportunity. I don't think it had anything to do with Montrez. Had us missing free throws, you know, front end of one and ones, missing two. You can't beat good teams and shoot 60% from the free throw line. You just can't do it. You can beat teams that maybe aren't as good, but you're not beating good teams if you can't make them. And we didn't.
Start mission the first half, what happened there, and then how did you try to settle your best
back there? You'd have to ask the officials. I don't know what happened other than they said he threw a punch. So that's why he was, obviously tossed. So I don't know. It was the smallest guy on our team that he threw the punch at BP. So he probably could have just grabbed him and been fine. So I don't know. Told our guys, keep your composure and just play basketball and not get caught up in anything silly. And I thought they did that.
That lineup you put out there for that punch against Avery, Brandon, unlikely five for rotation,
I thought they did a better job of any of our guards of sharing the ball, making the extra pass, not rushing, being a little more patient. DJ was terrific. I think he gave you another glimpse of his future today. And then Avery's a guy that, he hasn't played a lot, but over the course of the last week to 10 days, I've been saying he's starting to come. He's starting to get better. And we felt like today, with his toughness and his ability to handle the basketball, and I really didn't want to do it. I wanted to wait one more game before we really got him deep in the mix. But where we were, how we were playing, and the game itself dictated, hey, put him in. And he played well. And I think it's due to how he's practiced. Just got to, again, I think we can be a good basketball team. Got to compete like that every day. Got to prepare like that every day. And got to get in the gym. And, if you're not shooting free throws like you need to, then get in there and shoot some more. And that's what we've been doing. We're coming off a game a couple games ago, Ole Miss, we're 15 for 15 second half. So if you can figure it out, help me out, because it just varies from game to game. Some games we make them, some games we don't. But I think we're a team that got some different pieces, and I think we need some guys that we can count on every night. And if we can do that, we got a chance to be good. But if it's a guessing game from game to game, we're gonna have nights where we struggle. Hey, he played, he was good. I thought their guards did a tremendous job yo-yoing with the ball screen and eventually getting numbers by us, I thought our bigs did a pretty good job showing, taking away the initial drive, but I'm not convinced our guard. I'll have to go back and watch the tape, but I'm not convinced our guards did a great job of getting back and getting their numbers in front. And because of it, Jones and Rozier made us pay.
All right, buddy.
All right, guys. Have a Merry Christmas.